August 1980. 900 years since the Doomsday Book, at least three churches have stood on this site. The present Victorian church is now unsafe, and in 50 years will be a ruin unless action can be taken now. The church is sitting on a lime mortar raft, which is on a layer of topsoil on top of many old graves. As well as mining substance causing problems, the raft and the church kept moving, causing the pillars to crack. With these conditions, the church is far too heavy to stand on its own foundations. February 1981. The church is now closed to the public as an archaeological team dig out two bits of the floor to reveal Victorian floor level and medieval floor levels of earlier churches. In the nave, a second hole of about 18 feet deep shows a wall of St. Michael's Church of 18th century origin, also the wall of the 11th century church at the bottom of the hole. So an appeal was launched to the people of Heanor to help raise the money to rebuild the church. Missing as a pane of glass is removed from one of the windows in the south wall. Some of the roof tiles piled up. These will be used later for retiling. Most of the tiles have gone, leaving only the wooden slats. Slats have been removed. Only the stone walls remain. Lying useless among the rubble are thick wooden beams, some of 2 feet thick square, removed from the roof. partly demolished. With scaffolding on the south wall to aid easy removal of stone blocks, some to be reused later on. Glass taken out, views can be seen inside the church from the roadway. This view from the tower, only the north side of the church will remain untouched. In early October, one of the diggers making trenches to improve the foundations hit the ceiling of the Millamundi vault under the southeast corner floor. Mrs. Allsop of the local history society managed to take pictures in the vault showing some of the 14 coffins of the Mundi family who lived roughly 200 years ago. It was always known that the vault existed under the church, but not its exact position, because the entrance was sealed up when the Victorian church was built in 1868. Now they may never be seen again. The theme of the appeal now is to help build it. Sunday, 25 October, the church is a ruin. Only the north side and the tower remains. Built in 1470, the tower is in good condition except for roof repairs. So with the enormous weight of the church gone, properly founded brick columns will support the new church roof. The walls will be rebuilt to two-thirds of the original height. On this Sunday, a service is to be held in the ruins. All the rubble has been cleared up. During rebuilding work, all services normally being held in the church hall. In this particular service, the theme of the sermon was the word resurgam, which means I will rise again. As Jesus rose from the dead, so surely shall the church rise again. Each day for the Christian is a rising again day. The altar being made from planks supported on scaffolding poles. And the service being a communion service. Early November, the main brick support column for the roof has been built. Also, the dividing wall is nearly complete, for the church is to be split into two parts, one for the main church, and the other part being used as a church hall. Months later, a crane is in use for lifting the new metal girders into position on the support columns to form the basis of the roof. All of this work was done in one day, due to the costly hire of the crane. So the A sections to form the roof being fitted into place. By the new year 82, the first wooden slats are in position. Ceiling battens all in position. And a view from the north side shows most of the roof being retiled. As the edge of the roof has been trimmed off with wood, this will shortly be covered with stainless steel trimming.